Hello, hello, welcome back to my channel. I'm Kara, and so today we are talking about another relationship topic, and that is my partner's having a midlife crisis. All right, guys, so let me just break it down to you. Some of us may not come to that point in our life when we feel as though our prime years have passed us by or are about to. And we may want to explore, you know, what once was because of a certain reason. All right. So midlife crisis. Actually, the years that this sort of transition takes place, it used to be between the ages of like 45 and 60. Some people may carry it a little further out, like 65. Now it's happening earlier. Between the ages of like 35 and 55. So we're coming into this phase a little earlier than we once did because of the advancement of everything and, you know, evolving. Everyone's evolving. We're all looking better. And yeah, so that is another reason why many of us go into midlife crisis, because everything's moving so fast now. All right, so reasons why someone may begin to experience midlife crisis. Well, perhaps they have been reflecting on a time where he or she was, you know, popular, perhaps in high school, may have had, you know, all the guys or the girls, drove the best car, and since they've settled down and perhaps become married and had children, or maybe not, they may just have settled down and they're missing something. They miss that attention, you know, the experience of just feeling free and experiencing life, you know, in a more liberating way. And they may just want to experience that once again. And that's fine. And men typically do it a lot differently than women. And I'll delve into that a little later. But another reason could be is that back in the day, they may not have been the most attractive being or have had the most expensive car or even a car at all, you know, or may not have been the most popular person. But now, their body is fit, they have, you know, hair transplants, or you know, skin rejuvenations, their look has changed, make money now, whereas back then they probably was a little poor. So they have now, this person has evolved, you know, into a newer person, and they kind of want to share that by, you know, probably going out to maybe not a club but a lounge or a bar and getting back out there, or dating someone 15 years their junior to feel as though they are reliving their youth. And a lot of times, especially with men, when they don't have that sort of attention that everyone else was experiencing when they were young, they're far more likely to seek that out than a woman, because, you know, it's nothing for a woman to get any kind of attention. So a man is more apt to go out and seek attention that he never really got. Perhaps he didn't have, you know, the looks, or his esteem wasn't where it could have been, but now he has that, and with a little money, maybe a better car, and it shows. Especially with men, it really shows when they are going through a midlife crisis. Like, the way they think changes, their behavior, appearance, especially the appearance. Like, it's so weird to me to see, like, older men dressing like younger guys, you know, with a cap, you know, and shorts and sneakers and a t-shirt, and it's like, okay, I mean, you look good, but it just looks funny because it should be placed on someone who's younger. you know, you should, as we grow older, we should always try to at least dress somewhat age appropriate. But for men, they really go out to experience their prime years once again that have long ago has passed them. And yeah, but another reason could be is because perhaps they are in a marriage that, or a long-term relationship, that is just mundane, you know? There isn't any spice anymore, and, you know, they may have a partner who's just too conventional, was never the wild type, and that could be because if you're with a partner and you're going through this sort of change experience, your partner may have experienced all of what he or she needed from their younger years, like have had the attention and their esteem was where it was and they were always confident. And so they got a lot out of their younger years. Or they've experienced life almost to its capacity or for what they needed to experience. We all experience life on a different level. So some may not need as much experience as others. But your partner may feel fulfilled in this. And it may not just be trying to be young if you experience this crisis thing. It could just be wanting to experience other things that you never thought you could do. And it may come off a little crazy to your friends or whatever, but you may want to challenge yourself once again just for the whole experience and riskiness of it. Because usually when people go through a change, they usually try to do risky things like buy a really expensive car that they really don't need or whatever, or go bungee jumping, do something that is just a little crazy, but it makes sense to them. And so, yeah, once again, with men really go all out. But for a woman, it's kind of hard. It's a little challenging to tell if she's going through this sort of change, simply because most women, and I say most women have always looked their best. They've always worn heels and kept their hair done and their nails and worn makeup. So you can never really tell if she's trying to, you know, embrace her younger self, unless she is at a bar and she's turning it up and getting lit with a younger guy and she's out there dancing, or when she shows up to a family function with a younger person. So it's sort of hard to tell when a woman's kind of going through this change unless she's really getting out there and showing it. You know, the shorter skirts, which may look good on some older women, depending on how she's built, her frame. You know, it may not look too raunchy, but nevertheless, it's a little challenging to see that if your woman is going through the crisis. But you'll know it because she's open with it. And most men, and they'll try to subtly change their ways or subtly do certain things differently or go and hang out later. Just transition slowly, because that goes back to the male ego. You know, men like to do things at a slower pace. They try to pace themselves because they don't want to F it up as though they probably did when they were younger. But with a woman, and she's usually confident and secure, and she just gets out there, grab her younger guy, or go to a club and express herself as though she's a teen again. You know, change her hair color, put purple highlights or lowlights in her hair. Just all those type of things we do to make ourselves feel as though we're turning back the clock so that we can feel younger. You know, but yeah, midlife crisis, most people will go through it at some point. And like I said, in today's society, we're going to go through it a little sooner. So you may see, and this is why you say 50 is the new 40 and 40 is the new 30. We're all trying to wind back the clock, and we're doing it. We're doing well with it, but it's not a bad thing. It's just you have to know your limit, not to go too overboard. For instance, if you are 65, you probably shouldn't date like an 18-year-old because it comes off a little creepy. Like, I mean, there's young, but then there's young, like younger. Yeah. So just, if you're going to go through this,